हेलो चिल्ड्रन, वी आर ऑन चैप्टर 5 वर्ब। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट लेसन 5 वर्ब। व्हाट इज अ वर्ब? वर्ब आर वर्ड्स इंडिकेटिंग एक्शन और स्टेट ऑफ बीइंग इन अ सेंटेंस। वर्ब्स इंडिकेटिंग एक्शन और स्टेट ऑफ बीइंग इन अ सेंटेंस। व्हाट इज अ वर्ब? वर्ब आर वर्ड्स इंडिकेटिंग एक्शन और स्टेट ऑफ बीइंग। व्हाट्स द स्टेट ऑफ बीइंग मीन्स? इट्स ए सिचुएशन। स्टेट ऑफ बीइंग मीन्स इट्स ए सिचुएशन। ए सेंटेंस रिमेन इनकम्प्लीट विदाउट द वर्ब। ए सेंटेंस रिमेन इनकम्प्लीट विदाउट ए वर्ब। सो वी कैन से वर्ब इज द इम्पोर्टेंट पार्ट of a sentence. The verb is the important part of a sentence, and also we can say it is the heart of the sentence. Verb is the heart of the sentence. So what's the definition of the verb again? Say it again. What's the definition of the verb? The verbs are words indicating action or state of being. It's a indicating action or state of being. So we can, I will ask you, what is the, we have heard that is finite verb, direct object, indirect object. What are all these? What are all these? Finite verb, direct object and indirect object. What are all these? What is a finite verb? Verb that have a definite tense are called a finite verb. Verb that have a definite tense are called a finite verb. And what is the direct object? We say no direct object, there is an indirect object. What's a direct object? A direct object is a noun or a pronoun that are directly received. The action of the verb is called direct object. So direct object receives the action directly from the verb. It is called a direct object. And what is an indirect object? An indirect object precedes the object. It tells who the verb indirectly tells and affects who is receiving the direct object. What is an indirect object? An indirect object precedes the direct object. It tells us who the verb indirectly affects and who is receiving the direct object. You can also take the page number 42. 42 page number, it's written here. And also there is a table here. You can open the textbook page number 42. So, the examples which is given here. Sarvani gave me a bag. Sarvani gave me a bag. Which is the verb here? Gave is the verb here. Gave is the verb here. And me is the indirect object. And a bag is the direct object. Me is the indirect object and the bag is the direct object. The second example which is given. Diksha loves flowers. So Diksha is the subject here. And what is the verb here? The verb is loves and flowers is the direct object. Flowers is the direct object. The third example which is given. The phone rang. The phone rang. Is there any object here? No. The sentence is incomplete. The phone rang. There is no object. So only the verb is written here. Which is the verb here in third sentence? The verb is rang. Okay. And the last fourth examples. The tiger is the national animal of India. Tiger is the national animal of India. Which is? Is. Which is the verb here? In the sentence, is the verb here. And the national animal of India is the complementary sentences. So we can see here, in the first examples which is given in your book, page number 42, gave, there are two objects. What are the objects? Gave, there are two objects here. That is me, indirect object, and a bag is the direct object. The second sentence, how many objects are there? Only one object, that is flowers. One object, that is flowers. And verb is loves. The third, how many objects are there? Oh, there is no object. In here only the verb is there. Okay. And the second, the third, fourth one is verb, and it is a complementary sentences. You know that. Okay. And here we see, we have already discussed that verb, the definition of the verb, action, it is indicate action or state of being. The verb is divided into two parts. What are the two parts the verb is divided into? The verb is divided into two parts. What are they? Transitive verb and intransitive verb. So transitive verb again divided into two parts, that is a verb with a direct object and verb with an indirect object. So now we will take here and discuss about what is transitive verb. What is a transitive verb? Page number 43 in your book. You can open the book on page number 43. What is a transitive verb? The verb which are having an object is called a transitive verb. What is a transitive verb? A verb which are having an object is called a transitive verb. So always, if it is transitive verb, there is always an object in a sentence. So we call it a transitive verb. And here, I have written a few examples here. You will see the first example, okay? The man loved his children. The man loved his children. The action is performed by whom? The man is performing the action and receiver is who? The children. So the man is the subject, the love is the verb here, and the children are the object. So the sentence is complete. So it is a transitive verb. The love here, it is the, this is a which is transitive verb. Okay. And the second example, the doctor cured him. Who cured him? The doctor cured him. Here cured is the action verb and him is the direct object. Okay. The sentence is complete. Who cured him? The doctor cured him. So it is a transitive, the cured is a transitive verb. And third example, she crossed the street. Here crossed is a transitive verb and which is the object in the sentence? The object is the street. So the sentence is complete. Subject, verb, object. So it is a crossed is a, here it is a transitive verb. And the fifth example, fourth example, Rohan kicked the ball. The Rohan is subject, kicked is verb, and object is, which one is the object here? Ball is the object. So the sentence is complete. The object was already here. Rohan, what kicked? Rohan kicked what? Ball. So we get the answer already. Rohan kicked the ball. Subject, verb, object. So it is a, this kicked is a transitive verb. Okay. Now we will go to the intransitive verb. What is an intransitive verb? Verb that do not require an object to complete the sentence, complete their meaning, are called intransitive verb. What is an intransitive verb? Just opposite to the transitive verb. Okay. Verb that do not require an object to complete their meaning is called intransitive verb. Okay. There is no need an object to complete the sentence. That is called intransitive verb. And we have already said that there is the transitive verb has also, there are two types of intransitive verb. There are two types of intransitive verb, that is page number in your book, page number 43, it is written verb of action and a verb of being. What is the verb of action? That express verb of action, that express an action or a physical abilities is called a verb of action. That express verb of action that express actions or a physical abilities. एक्टिविटीज है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल रन, जम्प, राइट, रीड, डांस, ऑल दीज कम्स अंडर विच एक्शन, वर्ब ऑफ एक्शन. ओके, एंड नाउ वी टेक द वर्ब ऑफ बीइंग. व्हाट इज द वर्ब ऑफ बीइंग? इट इज ए सिचुएशन. वर्ब ऑफ बीइंग इज ए सिचुएशन. फॉर एग्जाम्पल बी, हैव, लाइक, थिंक, is, am, are, all these kind of comes under a verb of being. Okay, so you remember what is transitive verb? A verb that needs to complete their meaning is called an intransitive verb. And now I have written a few examples of intransitive verb. You can look at here. The first one, snow fell yesterday. Snow fell yesterday. Okay, here the subject and fell is the verb. Okay, and yesterday, is there any snow fell yesterday? Here we are not getting the answer. Okay, are we getting the answer here? Snow fell where? We are not getting any answer. There is no object here. The sentence is incomplete. So it is, this is a intransitive verb. Okay, so the second one, We failed in which subject? What subject? Nothing is given here. So already verb is here, but the answer is not given. We failed in which subject? We are not getting any answer here. We are not a direct object to link with the subject. We are not getting any direct object to link with the subject. We. We is the subject. Okay, we are not getting any to link with the subject V. So the action, the sentence is incomplete. So it is intransitive verb. And she is sleeping. Here also there is no object. So it is the verb is here. Yes, it is the intransitive verb. So I hope you understood what is transitive verb and intransitive verb. Okay. And also you have the exercises given in page number 44 in your grammar textbook, page number 44. Read the following passage, circle the transitive verb and underline their object. You will do it this exercise in your textbook. You will be circling the transitive verb and underlining the object. Okay, I will be also giving the answers for you. And page number 45, you have to do it. There are here, the words given below are jumbled order. Arrange them in correct order. It is in a jumbled order. You have to arrange them in correct order. That also you will be doing it in your English grammar textbook. The first one I will tell you. Okay. We, Roxy, our dog, call. So it is in a jumbled sentence. It is. So you have to arrange it in order. So the answer is we call our dog Roxy. That's the answer. So you will be doing it all this in your textbook. I hope you understood what is the verb, what is transitive verb, what is intransitive verb, and complete the exercises page number 45 and 44 in your textbook. Thank you, students.